In my tradition, in the Christian tradition, we speak about listening to God. That would be very important. And that moment when we hear God's voice, today, when you hear His voice, harden not your heart. That is a very important saying that's over and over repeated. And that means now, and now, at every moment, today, every moment. And we say that God is so simple that God has only one thing to say, and that is, I love you. That's all that God has to say, because God is love. But just as lovers will not say, well, I told you that 25 years ago, do you want to hear it again? I love you, yeah. But they will repeat it over and over in ever new ways, in poems, in caresses, in songs, in presents, in flowers, and find ever new ways of saying I love you. So God finds ever new ways of saying, and everything that is around, everything, every person, every situation, is another way of God saying I love you. And so for us to come alive to that, we have to learn those many different languages that God speaks. And God says I love you when we eat a strawberry in strawberry language, and that is not translatable into any other language. You just have to have tasted a strawberry. And so with everything there is, we have to learn the different languages. That's what I mean by coming alive. That's one of the aspects of living a spiritual life.
And I would say that sometimes God speaks with great subtlety and with a whisper. There's a story of Elijah in the Bible where he got into a terrible mess of too much enthusiasm, killing idolatrous priests of Baal, and going through the desert and fasting and realizing what he'd done wrong. And he came to the mountain, and there was a great wind, and commentaries, and God was not in the wind. And then there was the fire, and God was not in the fire. And then it says, and then the earthquake, and then it says, and then there was a soft, silent whisper. And it doesn't say God was in the soft, silent whisper, because you can't name that. But the soft, silent whisper, the subtlety.